At the minute, we've got the guards in place, so I cannot see the incoming supply cable's termination point. So I'm going to have to access this area here, and it says danger voltage. We're hoping that we've isolated it remotely. We know the main switch off, but care needs to be taken when entering this enclosure. So when we're going in here, again, be very careful, insulated screwdrivers, etc. So we're going to take off the side panels, and then we're going to remove this front cowling next. So before we start the safe isolation process, we must prove our voltage indicator on a known supply. I'm going to use a proving unit. So we're going to probe in like so, into one termination and then into the other of it. And hopefully we can see that the voltage shoots up, all our lights illuminate, and we go above the scale, off the limit. So we've proved our voltage indicator is ready to start the safe isolation procedure. Before you tell me how messy it is and use the tie wraps and what a disaster this looks like, this is a legacy panel. It's been wired by outside contractors, etc., and we're using it to prove a point for the safe isolation. I understand there's also a little plastic cap missing there. It's not essential, but it is missing. There'll be loads of things you'll be able to pick out for me. I'd appreciate it if you don't in the comments, because this is all about the isolation procedure. The caps in the bottom here are still in place, and I can't touch those live parts. I can't touch them actually with the caps down, but that they're in place. I'm going to need to move those out of the way before I start the safe isolation procedure. So just pull those down. Depending on what documentation you're reading, depends on which order these 10 tests are carried out. If you look on Net Services, their documentation about safe isolation, they talk about doing it, first of all, between two of the lines. So effectively starting at a potentially 400 volt test. I don't carry mine out in that way. I do it in a slightly different way. And this is something I spoke to with Sparky Ninja as well. I don't like the fact that if it was live, that once I probe onto one of the lines, the other tip's obviously going to go live and therefore potentially dangerous. So I like to do it in a slightly different order. Have a conversation with your AM2 or AM2S inspector and just confirm to him, if you do the 10 tests in the order that you're comfortable with, will he be acceptable, or would he like you to do it in a certain position, certain order? So I'm going to start off by doing what would be a 230 volt test if it was live. We're presuming it isn't because we've safely isolated it. So I'm going to test between the neutral and line conductor. I'm going to probe on in the safest possible order. So I've gone the least dangerous conductor first. So I've gone to the neutral, and then I go on to the line conductor. No volts at all. I come off the line conductor. I'm going to go to the next line. So I'm going to leave it on the neutral this time. I'm not going to take it off. So I go to the next one and L2, no volts, come off and go to L3. No volts, come off, and then I'll come off my neutral conductor. So I've done that in what's the safest possible manner, by going on the neutral first. I haven't made this tip live. If I've gone on L1 first and then on the neutral, your tip becomes live if the circuit was energized. That's the first three stages. L1, L2 and L3 tested to neutral in my sequence. Next, I'm going to test between the neutral and the protective conductor. This is a TNCS earthing arrangement, so you'll get a continuity beep. We understand that from classroom chat about how the neutral and earth are connected together. Again, I need to go in the safest order. Out the neutral and the protective conductor. The protective conductor is the safest terminal. So I'm going to probe onto that one and then onto the neutral. You'll hear a beep because that's a continuity, not a voltage reading. There's 0 volts there. And then I come off the neutral first, and then off my protective conductor. That's stage 4. I'm now going to test between individual lines to the protective conductor. So we're at stage 5 now in the testing sequence. I'm going to probe onto my protective conductor first, and then I'm going to do L1, L2 and L3. Very similar process to what we did with the neutral. So onto the protective conductor, and least dangerous one first, then onto the line conductor L1, no volts, off the line L2, no volts, L3, no volts, off L3, off the protective conductor. So we're now at a stage where we've only got a test between our line conductors. We're presuming, because of the tests we've carried out so far, it's actually isolated. So at this stage, when we're probing between two conductors, which we now expect to be dead, we haven't got any issues with livening the tips up. So we're into the final stages where we go between L1, and we're going to go into L2, I'm going to come off L2 and go into L3, and then we're going to come off L1 and go into L2. All of those had 0 volts. Okay, So it doesn't matter which order we come off. So before we can start confirming that absolutely the safe isolation procedure has been completed, we must prove that our instrument hasn't failed in the process. So we need to prove this before we suggest to our instructor that we are ready to start work. So probe back into our proving unit. Again, always tricky on camera. And there we go. We've proved our voltage indicator is working correctly. So at this stage, we can go back to the panel. That completes the 10 stages of testing the three-phase isolation of a, in this case, distribution board.